really a victory for South Korea. Arthur Urquiola reports.
A massive fireworks display lit up the Pyongyang sky as North Korea ended its first day of celebrating the 60th anniversary of the truce that ended its war with the South. The nation's leader, Kim Jong-un, who has made several public appearances lately to mark the occasion, watched with his officials. Earlier, Kim was out opening a new war museum in Pyongyang. He was there with Chinese Vice President Lee Yan-chao, who was in the city for the festivities. And with that, the Victorious Fatherland Liberation War Museum was officially opened. Kim and his delegation headed inside, passing a giant statue of his grandfather, Kim Il-sung, who launched the three-year war which ended in 1953. The museum features videos, dioramas, photographs, and statues depicting the war which the North hails as a victory. But over in Washington, U.S. President Barack Obama, who is paying tribute to veterans of the war at a memorial, had a different take on the events.
We can say with confidence, that war was no tie. Korea was a victory. When 50 million South Koreans live in freedom, a vibrant democracy, one of the world's most dynamic economies, in stark contrast to the repression and poverty of the North, that is a victory and that is your legacy.
The event was also marked at the United Nations Command in South Korea. Armistice Commission officials gathered at Panmunjom's Truce Village. They used the occasion to call on Pyongyang to take steps to dismantle its nuclear program and improve its relations with Seoul. Earlier this year, tensions were high with Pyongyang threatening war with the U.S. after the U.N. slapped sanctions on the reclusive state following a rocket test. Arthur Urquiola, ATV News.
There have been more protests in Tunisia in the hometown of slain secular opposition figure Mohamed Brahmi.
But first, now a roundup of international news. The U.S. has expressed grave concern after dozens were killed in violent clashes in Egypt.
The violence began Friday night when supporters of ousted President Mohamed Morsi tried to extend a sit-in to a major road and police fired tear gas. But Egypt's General Prosecutor's Office claims that Morsi supporters fired at police first. The state news agency also reported that the pro-Morsi crowd attacked security forces with shotguns, pistols and Molotov cocktails. Thousands of Morsi supporters have held a sit-in for more than 3 weeks outside a mosque in Nasser City. They're demanding that Morsi be reinstated as president and that dozens of Muslim Brotherhood leaders who were detained following his 3rd of July ouster be released. Bodies wrapped in white sheets were laid on the floor of a Brotherhood morgue, their names scrawled on the shrouds. Washington, treading a fine line with an important Arab ally and recipient of over $1 billion US dollars a year in American military aid, urged Egypt to pull back from the brink and called on Egyptian security forces to respect the right to peaceful protest. U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry spoke to two senior members of Egypt's army-installed interim cabinet, expressing his deep concern. Still, Brotherhood activists warned of worse bloodshed if the security forces did not back down. Police fired tear gas to disperse violent protests in the southern Tunisian town of Sidi Bouzid, cradle of the country's revolution and hometown of slain secular opposition figure Mohamed Brahmi. Thousands of protesters chanting anti-government slogans had earlier joined Brahmi's funeral march in the capital, Tunis. Down with the party of the Brotherhood, chanted mourners, referring to the ruling Ennahda party's affiliation with the regional Muslim Brotherhood religious group. Tensions have run high in Tunisia since Brahmi's assassination on Thursday, and large protests throughout the day were met with police tear gas. In a bid to stave off unrest amid intensifying protests, particularly in the capital, secular coalition partners of Tunisia's ruling Islamist party said they were in talks to reach a new power-sharing deal.
Sport news. Rack Cho's unbeaten run continues after the Hong Kong fighter triumphed over Thai challenger Rosalie Samore in a majority decision. Donning black shorts, Cho was restrained by his experienced opponent's heavy punches early on in their sixth-round bout in Macau last night. Two of the three judges ruled in Cho's favour, enabling him to extend his winning streak to double digits. American brand Snedeker heads into the final round of the Canadian Open with a one-stroke lead. The American dazzled the crowds with a 9-under 63. Sitting one stroke behind is David Linkmuth as the Swede looks for his maiden PGA Tour title. Overnight leader Hunter Mahan quit after hearing his wife had gone into labor. The weather forecast for the next few days: brightening up tomorrow with a top temperature of 32 degrees, but turning cloudy again later in the week. Here's a look at the weather around the world.
That's our main news for Sunday night. We'll have an update at 9. I'm Edna Tse.
I'm Raymond Yeo.
And I'm Anne-Marie Sim. Thanks for watching ATV. Good night.
Good night.
Just to remind you, tomorrow's main news and weather report will be telecast at 7:30. Stay tuned.